When will somebody put us out of our misery on CNN, CBS?
Yeah, I think, you know, there's always been speculation that Time Warner and CBS might get together for a variety of reasons. Maybe the biggest one is Time Warner is one of the few big media companies out there, the big conglomerates that does not own a broadcast network. And historically, they probably didn't want to own a broadcast network. But the broadcast television business has gotten a little bit better. They're getting
a little bit, yeah.
They're getting retransmission revenue. It kind of starts to look a little bit like a cable network. So if you're Time Warner, you're thinking about where do I deploy my capital? One of the discussion points out there in the media, you know, blogosphere, if you will, is perhaps CBS.
Top of the market? The stock's gone, I mean, it's the moon.
Right.
It's gone like from five to whatever.
Yeah, you're right. It'd be a very expensive deal. CBS is almost $30 billion in market cap. And quite frankly, I think this is a deal that probably does not happen, primarily because Viacom, Sumner Redstone has shown no indication of being a seller. He's the control shareholder. You know, I haven't seen Sumner Redstone sell anything in a long time, so much less a crown jewel asset such as CBS. So,
well, another reason, Paul, that we're talking about the potential for this deal is the media stocks have been darlings lately. They've become this hotbed of activity and merger speculation. Is there another one that you're looking at for a possible deal?
You know, I don't know. I think the stocks have just done tremendously well. The media sector overall, coming out of the financial crisis, has dramatically outperformed the market. The fundamentals are good. And one of the reasons the stocks are doing so well is because the companies are buying back stock. They're returning cash to shareholders. They're paying dividends. They're buying back stock. They're not making acquisitions. So I think the last thing investors want to see is another round of media M&A.
What does it have to do at all with the advertising market?
Yeah, the advertising market coming out of the recession has been very solid. You know, I think, you know, got crushed in 2009 when people were really concerned about the economy, but it has come back very solidly over the last several years. We'll get another data point in the next couple weeks.
Because we're upfronts. Yeah. That's happening now.
Yep.
My head is spinning. I've got you telling me that the major media companies are doing great. The ad business is great. I got a guy like Tim Armstrong the other day with AOL or his colleague Susan Line in crime. He's desperate. You know, they're going, no, forget about it. We're the future. Who's the future?
Well, I'll tell you, the future is Madison Avenue. As long as they can continue to generate or get their advertising clients to spend money, I think a lot of these companies are going to do well. Clearly, overall ad spending has been a decent business, 4 to 5% growth globally. But really what we're seeing is a shift from the older media to the newer media. Internet advertising is about a 15% grower. So, you know, Tim Armstrong at AOL is absolutely correct. In the overall scheme of things, he's in a good spot.
But, you know, I read over the weekend, I kid Sarah about this, I actually sat down and really looked at the New York Times earnings report. Print down 11%. Digital was a mishmash, +4, -6 even. A minus number on digital growth. Who is the winner here? When you talk about a 15% gross return.
Yeah, the winners really are the big search and display advertising companies, such as Google on search, Facebook on display advertising, social media. Search, display, and social are the best growth stories on the internet.
Which is Facebook, Google,
Yahoo,
AOL.
I'm glad you brought up
Facebook. Facebook's going to be a big theme today as well. And we mentioned mobile ads are a key to growth, but that's not it. There's some speculation that people are spending less time on Facebook these days.
That's right. I think the growth of Facebook is really not so much the engagement of the existing consumers, although that's very important. But I think if you're Facebook, you need to look, and they are on as a global story. They are literally all over the world, and they will continue. Where they're seeing their best growth is outside of North America.